Okay, so hello guys, it's a sunny Tuesday and I've got another weathering technique just to kind of show you how to do today. So today I'm going to be using oil paints and white spirit to create the rust effect that you can see here on this model. Okay, so it looks pretty cool and it is actually not that difficult to do. I learned how to do it from the Forge World Imperial Armour Modelling Masterclass, Volume 2 and 1. More so 1, actually. But yeah, so I learned how to do this from there, and I thought I'd just pass on a little bit of that knowledge. I would recommend reading the book, just to get a really good idea of how it works and what you need. Okay? So, what do I think you need? So what I've been using is just normal white spirit. I got the cheapest white spirit I can find from Wilkinson's. Got a big old pot. That was about a fiver, okay? You can get artist quality thinners for oils. They're a bit more expensive and they don't smell quite as bad, but if you don't mind the smell, then they're absolutely fine. Okay, I also got a selection of oil paints. So I got some burnt sienna, which is quite useful. Got some Indian red, which hasn't been that useful, I will be honest. And I got some burnt umber. Okay. These are all, they say they're water mixable, but oils generally aren't. It's oil paint. Okay. So the thing about oil, for those of you who don't know, excuse me, sorry. For those of you who don't know about oil paints, they are obviously oil based, so they're not water soluble. Okay, so you have to use solvent thinners like white spirit or terps to clean them up. So it can be quite messy if you don't know what you're doing. I definitely wouldn't recommend this for someone who isn't the cleanest of painters, or I generally wouldn't recommend it for a younger person. But if you think you're capable of doing it, then go for it, guys. You're also going to need an airbrush. I'd recommend putting your airbrush on a compressor just so you can turn it on and off for this one. You're going to need some coffee stirrers. I went into Costa Coffee and just got a handful of them. I'm sure you could probably go to Starbucks or whatever, get some, or even buy some if you're not the taking type. Probably recommend some cotton buds, or for all you Yanks out there, Q-tips, I believe you call them. And a rough as anything old paintbrush. Okay, what I've done is I've decanted some of the oil paint into some of the little tubs that Games Workshop do with their 40k and fantasy basing kits, and I've just stuck in a little bit of white spirit in there just to keep it wet. Now the oil on its own without the white spirit is probably going to take about a month to set. Okay, that blob there will never set in the centre, only the outside will set. With the white spirit, it will set a bit faster, okay, and it will thin it down. So I've gone for, there's the burnt umber, that's the burnt sienna, I think. No, this is the burnt sienna, the other one was the Indian red, and this is the burnt sienna. So, there we go. Okay, so that's everything you need to get started. You also need some models, obviously, to paint. I'm going to hook this up onto my tripod and get started showing you how to do the actual technique. See you in a second, guys. Okay, so, right, I do apologise if you get a bit of head in there. I do apologise if you get hands in there, but I am actually working on this for my my own personal collection. I am actually painting this. So what we're going to do, what we're going to start off with is fill your airbrush with white spirit, okay? So you're going to need that before anything else, because for this one, you'll see why in just a minute, actually. Okay, so the first thing I do, just to get a feel for it, is I take my burnt umber mix in this pot. I get a kind of medium density bit on my brush. I'll stick that in the back for now. And then take your lolly stick, and your paintbrush and just start to flick a little bit, just a small patch on there, okay? Now you can put a little bit more on, because the thing about than you want, because the thing about it is the airbrush with the white spirit is actually going to blast most of it away. So we're going to turn on the airbrush and just spray a little bit of white spirit over the top, and that just breaks it up a bit and makes it run. So if we keep doing that consecutively, what you end up with is just quite a nice build-up of kind of splattered, I don't know, rusty.
I've been doing it all morning.
Not spilling it once. Put it on camera and I spill it. So I'm going to keep trying this then. Let's have a go. There you go. Okay. So what we do is we just keep building it up. I'm now keeping the airbrush between my legs. Oh, dear me. So what's happening is my mix has actually had all morning to thin down. So it's gotten a little bit too thin, as you can probably see there, hopefully. Okay. So what I'm going to do is just get some more burnt umber. Some more burnt umber paint and add that to our mix. Okay. So the paints are a little bit expensive. I mean, I paid £4.70 a tube for them, but to be honest, the amount you're going to get out of it, you're never going to need to replace them as a modeler, you know. Right, so there's a little bit more. This is quite heavy actually, this one that I've just done. So, oh, hello. And as you can see, you can kind of alternate quite quickly. You just get a really natural aged look to it. Like, I want this to look like it's been sat around for a long time. So there we go. Okay, that's just with the burnt umber, that is. In fact, what I'll do, I'll get up just to check that's in for you. So, there you go, folks. That is just with the burnt umber at the moment. What you can do, you can layer a couple of different colours onto there, and that will give you more depth and a much richer kind of look to your model and to the rusting that you're doing on it. So what I'm going to do, I don't actually like the Indian red, so I'm going to use the burnt sienna, which I've thinned down loads, but I'm going to take a big chunky bit. I'm gonna go onto this. Now, I don't know whether it's a better idea to go dark then light with this, or if it's better to go light then dark. I've got a feeling dark then light, although I don't know. Just blasted off a little bit too much there. I feel that I got a bit carried away. So there we go. Okay. There's some quite large spots here, and I'm not sure whether I like them or not. But
kind of pull them out a bit. Okay. So I think I'm going to leave that one there.
I think. Some of you may be wondering why I said you need
cotton buds. I have been using cotton buds just to kind of stab at bits where I like it, but it's just a little bit too strong and the airbrush will just blast away way too much, which I don't need on actually. So yeah, I just kind of dab at bits that I'm not too pleased with it because there's a little bit too much on. Which can happen really easily with stuff like this. Like I said, it's not a definite kind of way of working. Some bits get a lot more clogged up than others. What you can do to kind of avoid that is you can start painting bits on. Just like that. And then you can give it a quick blast, turn that off, and then actually wipe it away. So it's just a really nice thing to play with. So I'm going to carry on and I'm going to let you leave me to it. And then I will put up some pictures when these are all done. So cheers for watching, guys. I will speak to you all soon. If you've got any questions, don't hesitate to ask, as always. If I've done anything wrong, please let me know. If you know a better way of working, I know you can mix weathering dyes, not weathering dyes, weathering powders into these. So I might give that a whirl too, see how that works out. But as I said, cheers for watching. Speak to you all soon. Bye bye.